guys, it's Haffa. I'm back again, and this is going to be a haul. I haven't done a haul in a little while, and I'm not technically supposed to be buying anything. Most of these were bought before I myself imposed kind of no-buy type thing. And a lot of these were bought during February, except for one or two parts of it, which were bought after that. And they're from a bunch of different places, so this one could be a little bit of a long one because there's quite a bit of it. So if you want to like grab a coffee or something, like pause now, go do that, get a snack, something like that, because this could take a little while. So I will start with things that are bought online. I usually buy through Ozsale or Cosmetic Kitchen, which are both online retailers in Australia that do discount type stuff. Cosmetic Kitchen is one of the best places for low price nail polishes. I actually don't have anything from Cosmetic Kitchen, but I'm mentioning them anyway because I like shopping there. You can get sinful colours there a lot cheaper than you can buy in, say, Kmart or Priceline, in case you're in Australia and you're wondering. Cosmeticcapital.com.au. Check it out. The other place is Ozsale. What they do is they have a whole bunch of sales from different brands and stuff where the stuff is quite reduced. It's usually stuff that is out of season or wasn't very popular overseas or whatever. A lot of it comes from like America and places like that. They have a lot of brands like Kala, which is kind of like a beauty brand that does knockoffs of higher end stuff, like the Real Technique sponges type thing and brushes and yeah, anything that's kind of gimmicky, they will have a version of it, but much, much cheaper. So I bought a few things off of Ozsale. A few of them were like Kala type things. I'm pretty sure they're from Kala. And some others were brushes that were interesting looking. So the first one is these. They look like Real Technique sponges, but they're not. I think they're Kala ones. They don't actually have a brand on them. But yeah, they were probably like $5 or something for two. I have not actually tried them out, so I don't know how they compare. The Real Techniques Miracle Complexion Sponge is the one that I use all the time because, frankly, I can't afford a beauty blender. So yeah, I'll be interested to try these out and see whether they're comparable in any way. So if you want to see a comparison between the Real Techniques and this one and see whether this one's actually any good, then leave me a comment down below and I will do that at some stage. One of the other things I bought from that sale was a silly sponge. I paid a lot less. This is like, I paid like $4 or something. This is not like the $12 that you buy for the Molly Cosmetics one. I have no idea if it's any good because I have not actually bothered to try it yet. It's been sitting there waiting for me to do this haul, actually. And you know, I think that the whole silly sponge thing is a bit like last week type thing. So if you want to see me use the silly sponge and see what my impression is as like an everyday average kind of person, again, leave me a comment down below. I can give that a go. The next thing is this brush cleanery thing. I'll take this one out of the packaging. It's basically it's called a brush egg. Basically it looks like half an egg. Because I got purple, because like why not? And you're supposed to like dampen your brush, soap it, and clean it as such. So yeah, interesting. I haven't actually tried it, clearly. I probably should, because, like, my brushes need cleaning again. It's like when you do dishes, they just seem to need to be done again. So, speaking of brushes, I bought a whole bunch of different ones online. So, the first ones I bought were these ones here. They were like a pack of six. There's three face brushes and three eye brushes. I have actually been using them, so they are a little tiny bit dirty. They're like synthetic brushes, purple on the top, but they have these really cool like rainbow textured type bottoms to them, which I thought were like really, really cute. And this, I saw these right at the time that the whole unicorn brush thing started to happen, and I didn't realize that was even a thing. But I saw these and I thought they looked really cute, so I bought them. And they're actually not bad brushes. They are actually quite soft. I have been using them, which is why they're a little bit dirty. I use, this one is my current blusher brush, and it does the job. I can't complain. They're actually quite nice brushes. Again, they need cleaning. And then a couple of weeks later, I saw these ones. I haven't actually taken them out of the packaging. These ones are the unicorn horn type ones. They weren't super expensive. I think I paid like $10 for these five brushes. There's four face brushes and one eye brush. I'll just take the eye brush out. So they have the unicorn horn handle on them. They're quite lightweight, and then they have almost like a rainbow, but like pink, blue, purple, yellow, or green, or something in the bristles on the end. So the bristles, if it would focus, you'll be able to see that. Yeah, so the bristles are all like pastel coloured. They're kind of cute. Maybe not quite as soft as the rainbow handled ones. Whoop, let's try a similar type of brush. I don't know. They're about the same. This is like the blusher brush. The handles are considerably longer though. Which is, you know, if you're trying to just like do really, really light, it gives you that option of doing that because the handles are so long. With a shorter handle, it's actually harder to control pressure. Because one of the ways that you control pressure with a brush is to hold it further down the handle. So this one is a, except for the strand, it's like a flat-topped complexion type brush. Then there's a fluffier, like, powder type brush. And the handles are faintly purple. They're not like super iridescent or anything, they're just faintly purple. And then this one, which I'm thinking is probably like a contoury type brush, because it's actually quite narrow. But they are kind of cool. So I got those. It's not like I actually need brushes, but I haven't bought any for ages. So. And then I got these. Now this has Storybook on it. And if you know what Storybook cosmetics are, you'll know that they're this brand that were claiming to do all of this Harry Potter inspired type stuff. And there was a little bit of controversy, if I remember. I got these on Oz sale in one of their sales. They had these brushes and they just said like wand brushes, and it did not say that they were Storybook Cosmetic ones. So getting a little pouch that says Storybook Cosmetics, I was actually surprised. I thought they were a rip-off of the Storybook Cosmetics ones. Apparently, maybe not. I'm not 100% sure. However, these are the brushes. Now, I can tell you, these are heavy. The handles are made of metal. They're actually kind of heavy. I have no idea which one's which and who they're supposed to align with. This one looks like it's got a bird or I don't know, some kind of animal on the end of it. I'm not really sure what they're supposed to be. It's a flat, fairly small flat kind of shadow. Maybe it's like a really tiny concealer brush. This one, again, I have no idea what this is supposed to be. It is kind of heavy. This one's more of like a large pencil brush. This one is another like flat shader. It's a bit wonky. I think it's actually supposed to be like that. This one is, I suppose, supposed to be a blender brush. Judging by the top one. But the bristles are like really uneven. I don't know if you're going to be able to see. Focus camera. See how uneven those little bristles are?
Wow.
And this one is like another blender fluffy type brush with bobbly things. Interestingly enough, the bristles on these are not very soft. They're not like scratchy, like horribly scratchy. But they're not as, like these ones feel softer. This brush is also heaps denser, which probably not the best one to judge it against. Yeah, they're just, I don't know. Yeah, see, this one feels softer. This one feels more dense. And this one, funnily enough, these ones were actually slightly more expensive. Not that expensive, but it's more expensive. These ones feel like the worst quality, quite frankly. The bristles on the ends are like super uneven and they weren't like trimmed properly. And I don't know if you can, I mean, this one here, whoops, this one here is the worst one for unevenness. But that one there, it doesn't even look like it was cut properly. They're not very good quality, quite frankly. So, I don't know what they're going to be like. I haven't tried them, but again, they are actually really heavy in the hand. You wouldn't want to be doing a lot of makeup with these because I think you'd get fatigue in your hands from them. I'm just saying. Okay, let's move on. I was in Kmart. Kmart Australia is not like Kmart in other places. I was looking around and they had a couple of e.l.f. Matte lip creams. What are they called exactly? It's not written on the box, sorry. Matte lip colour. They had them discounted. $4 in Australia is actually cheap. So this one is called Coral. I haven't actually swatched these. No idea. So that one's the Coral one. It's actually pretty. And the other one is Rich Red. Just kind of like a pinky red. But the fact that they were on sale, I'm happy with that. Because I quite like these. I have Tea Rose, which has taken me forever to work through. I'm still working through it. And the other thing I saw was these tweezers, which it doesn't take a genius to work out why I bought these tweezers. They had a whole bunch of other stuff as well, but I only bought the tweezers. They had other things that I thought, ooh. And because they're iridescent, I recently bought myself some iridescent nail tools from Born Pretty. So these are just, they look like anodized niobium, which is a metal I used to use when I was chainmailer. So pretty. So yeah, they kind of match my nail tool, even though they're from completely different locations. So yeah, got those from Kmart. They're kind of cute. Okay, and then I was in, just before my birthday, I had a gift card I was given last year that I hadn't actually used up, and it ran out 2 days before my birthday. And my birthday was at the end of February, so it tells you how long these have been sitting. Haven't swatched them, unfortunately. Just can't really show you what they look like. I have a whole bunch of nail polishes here, so if you want to see the swatchy videos or swatches of these nail polishes that are in here, let me know. I'm just going to haul them right now. So, because the gift card I had was to the Terry White chemist that we have here, which is where they sell Ultra 3, even though it's not as cheap as buying it online, I figured I'd use up my card. So I got this one, which is called Bouquet, which is a pink with a sort of pinky purple iridescence to it, shift to it. Super pretty. I think it's the only shimmery one of the ones I bought too. This one, which is called Flower Power, which is a soft peachy kind of tone. Excuse the dog going nuts in the background. The dog down the back started barking. Lavender Fields, which is a very soft purple. I think it's probably lighter than You're Such a Budapest. I'd have to compare them to actually tell, but it's in that same kind of vein, like a very soft lavendery shade, whereas You're Such a Budapest is more lilac than lavender, so there'll be that difference. Then we have Soft Hydrangea, which is a super light greyed out sort of blue. A hydrangea kind of colour, really, which is super pretty. This one has a very slight shimmer to it. I don't know whether that would translate to the nail. As I said, I have not swatched. This one is called Violet Rumble. It's quite pink, but with a little bit of a purple shift to it. Then we have It's a Bit Grey, which is a dark green-grey. Kind of just looks like kind of green, but it's actually a grey. It's quite a nice. It's the kind of green I like. Definitely cream. And the last one is called My Macaroon, which is like chocolate brown. it's just a nice creamy chocolate brown. Probably be really good for nail art. I use Ultra 3 a lot for nail art. They work really, really well for that. Then I was in Target in the city, and I did buy some more nail polishes, like I need them, but that runs on oil, and they're pretty colours. So I have three from L'Oreal, these little tiny ones from L'Oreal. We have Spicy Orange, which is not one of the ones I have. I didn't double up on anything that I already have. So Spicy Orange is kind of like a reddish orange, just a cream. I have Banana Pop, which is a really nice looking sunshiny yellow. And then this one, which is called Lush Tangerine, which is a nice orange. These would actually make a really good sunset type mani. And then there was this one from the it was like for $1.50. It's an essence one for $1.50. I think they're like $4 normally, something like that. It's from one of the collections. I just need to the pastels collection. Can't remove the sticker. It is a shimmery light blue. It actually makes me think of Cinderella. This colour makes me think of Cinderella. It might be a little frosty. I'm not going to lie. It has the potential of being a little frosty. But it's cute. And I liked it. And it was super duper cheap. And then I bought... They had a new collection out in Australia. Now, I know the space ones with holographics are out overseas, but I have not seen those in Australia. We still don't even have those bottles, like the square, rectangular type bottles. We still only have these bottles. But there was this collection there that I had not seen before. So I bought the four that were in the collection. They are Winter Glow, is the name of the line. And there are, four polishes in this line. So the first one is Icy Matte. It's from the ones that are Icy Matte. This one says Icy Ice. See, the bottles are like really, really frosted. But if you have a look up here where the sticky tape is, get a better idea of what you're getting. It's kind of like this grey with silver. But it's supposed to be a matte. And I'm like... super curious to see what it looks like because I haven't swatched them. I've literally been waiting to do like a video, so I haven't swatched any of this stuff, and I've been really bad about doing videos. not functioning the best at the moment. I'm just gonna. This one has the best name. I'll get to it in a minute. I swear. So I'm just gonna put a coat of these on. So this one is Icy Ice. I love the brushes that Essence have been doing. Did I mention they were Essence? See, Essence has the nice brushes, nice wide brushes. I just let that dry down a bit and then I'll come back. The other one from the Icy Matte line is this red one. Focus the camera. Is this red one, which is called Miss Frost. These are going to look great with or without top coat, like matte or not matte. Okay, and then the other ones are the Luminous Glow ones. So there's this one which is Let It Glow. Ah, that's a good pun, isn't it? It's kind of like a pale pinky with a bluey green iridescence to it, which I guess is why they call it Luminous Glow. And they are surprisingly not that sheer, considering the colour. It's like a really soft colour. You might need two coats, but it still looks pretty good. And the last one is a purple, like super pale purple. This one is called Luminosi. And it's a very light purple with an iridescence, which is kind of like a pinky iridescence to it. Those mattes dry down really nice and quickly, like just as I've been speaking to you, and like I'm not going to edit this bit out so you can see just how quickly they dry down. So we have Icy Ice, I really like the look of that. Then we have, Miss Frost. And where the tape is gives you an idea of what they look like when they're wet, and then if you put like a top coat on. And take into account, there's only one coat. They have really nice coverage for one coat, like one quick messy coat on the nails. This one is Let It Glow. No, I'm not flipping you the bird. Super pretty. Nice soft, like it's almost like a bridal type of thing. I like that. And Luminosi. As I said, I've only put one coat on. Two coats would probably build the colour up quite a bit and change it just a little bit, but those are really nice. I wasn't going to do them, but I was fiddling with them and they were like really cool. So that was everything from Target, and last but not least was a shopping trip to Priceline. Now, Priceline recently had a 40% off makeup sale, and one of the things that was in that sale was something that I had been eyeing off for a while, which was this. Do you know what this is? This is the NYX Liquid Suede Vault. It has 24 mini NYX Liquid Shade and Liquid Suede lipsticks in it. As you can see, I haven't even opened it, so it's got like some really bizarro colours like down here, and then it's got some more normal kinds of shades as well. Now, normally in Australia, this retails for $79, and at 40% off, it was just too good to like walk away from, basically. So with that, I did actually get some other things, and The entire price of everything that I bought was $79 and I think 32 cents. So with 40% off everything, it was just a great, great deal. So I got the CoverGirl Max Volume Flamed Out Mascara. This is one of the ones I've been wanting to try. I got the CoverGirl Clean Invisible Concealer in Light. I'm working my way through trying different concealers. I wanted to pick up another Maybelline Fit Me, but they didn't have the one that I wanted. But they did have something I've been trying to get for ages, but never been able to get when it's on sale, is the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Eraser Dark Circles in Light Pale. Because I've been wanting to try this one, because apparently it's like really, really good. And I won't pay full price in Australia for this, so getting it 40% off was well worth it. And I also got, because I've been wanting to... This looks really weird in the packaging. I've been wanting to try the NYX lingerie, and I wanted Embellish ever since I... Embellishment, ever since I saw the first swatch video, which I think was Biohazard Beauty, Tori from Biohazardous Beauty. Ever since I saw her video on it, I wanted Embellishment. And as a NYX, I don't generally buy makeup full price if I can avoid it. And NYX is actually not that cheap in Australia. Now, this has never been opened, but... Look, I don't know if you can see it. Come on, focus. Look at those weird lines. It's almost like it's dried out, but it's never been opened. I don't know. It's fine. It's just the consistency of it is quite kind of thicky. It's thick. That's just a surprise because I've never seen it before. So that there is Embellishment, which kind of looks different on me to what I was expecting. It looks kind of almost different in the tube, but it's the one that's got more of all of the, because they're all like really neutral, these lingerie ones. This is the one with like more pink base to it, which is why I wanted that one. So yeah, that is everything that I have. Oh, and then, sorry, there was one more that I bought at the same time, and this is the Astralis Matchmaker. This is like the Cover Effects customizing drops and all of those other ones that you get in different brands. This is just the Astralis version of it. Like most Power Girls, I have that problem with not being able to get foundations that are quite light enough for me. This has a very distinct pink tone to it, which I don't know if most people are aware of this. It is very white, but it has like a very slight pink. Actually reminds me a lot of the liquid highlighter that we used to use when I was doing my beauty course, that we'd put on under foundation. But I can see how it would certainly like lighten a foundation. Yeah, so that is everything that I have bought recently. If you want to see a swatch video for this, which there are like hundreds of them on YouTube, if you're really interested, let me know. And I can, it probably wouldn't be lip swatches, but I can still do a swatch video if you really want me to. If there's anything else that I've just showed you that you want to see more about, then leave me a comment down below. Click the subscribe button. Don't forget to click the bell so you get notified when I upload new videos. And leave me a comment down below. I try to respond to all comments. And I'll see you in my next video. See ya.